Hi, today I'm going to be working in this journal. I think I'm at my last empty spread, which was going to be like the grand finale, so we'll see how I like it. But as a collector of frog images, I wanted a frog spread in my and masse glue book that I've been working in for a bit. So most of the pages are already filled, and I've talked a little bit about it before and showed you some of the process. So what I'll do is just get started and see if we can fill a page with these images. If you don't know what an en masse glue book is, you can check out my first video on the subject where I explain how I found inspiration and got started, and also how I picked my themes. One of my themes is frogs, and that is because, like I said, I've collected images of frogs, and my obsession, I can actually trace it back to when I was maybe 13 or 14 and got to write an essay on any subject, and for some reason, which I do not remember, but I wrote an essay about a tree frog in the rainforest who was so sad and devastated because he could hear the forest machines coming closer and cutting down his beloved trees. So I wrote that essay and got a lot of credits for it, and also I drew the tree frog image to have as the cover of that essay before I turned it in to my teacher. And I guess the process of writing about him and drawing that image, it just made me feel close to that frog. And for my entire life since then, I've been interested in frog images. I don't think I would want to have a frog like in a real frog in a terrarium, because they have to eat live food, like real live insects, and I'm not really interested in that, which is sad because it would be perfect to have a little cute frog friend. So this part is sped up and we're just going to be gluing down the images, but that's the background of me becoming interested in frogs, and maybe even a little bit obsessed. done with my frog spread. I still have a lot of images left, so I can either do the thought about a very long time project of a themed glue book on frogs, but I don't think I have that much, so I probably will just use these in my art journal or art in some way. And this is my finished glue book and mass frog spread. Really happy with how it came out. I think this is the cutest of all of these guys, but I'm also very partial to this kind of frog with the red eyes. Did it some kind of tree frog? This is from an article from a magazine that I used to work for, so I've had it for a long time. And it says, "We like frogs." And description of different kind of things we like about them. Especially their cool feet with little circles on. Their little suction cups. I don't know if it's called that, but... a mosaic frog, a drawn frog, and I think this image is from a book, as you can see from the fold, and I just wanted to keep it anyway because he's so awesome. Kind of looks like a lizard because you can't see the body, but it's a frog for sure. And I think this one is from a poster, actually, the backside of a big poster that I had on my wall for a long time, and then I didn't need it. I cut the backside frog out to save him, and yeah, those are my little amphibian friends, and I added this because it's on cardstock as a little flap up so you could see the probably quite small flower bud with a even tinier frog hanging from it. Because frogs can be really, really small. Especially the tree frogs like that. And a toad, and he got to stay too. So that is my entire spread, and I'm so happy about it. Maybe in my next video I will show you some real life frogs. If you're subscribed, you will see what that thought and idea is all about. It's an old video that I haven't uploaded. So yeah, that's something to look forward to. If you are subscribed, of course. And in any case, I would love to know, do you have any relationships with frogs? Or am I the only one who's crazy like that? Or do you have any other animals that you are obsessed with? Let me know in the comments below. I would love to know. Thank you so much for watching this video and giving it a thumbs up. Bye!